Hi guys, in this video we are going to discuss HARQ, or the Hybrid Automatic Repeat Request. So what is HARQ? Retransmission is an important part to ensure transmission quality. So HARQ is one of the retransmission systems in 5G that utilizes the MAC. It uses ACK or NAC feedback on its downlink and uplink transmissions, or what we called traffic. This is where the HARQ in the MAC structure. HARQ is a stop and wait protocol with multiple processes. In each process, it waits till it gets an ACK to send a new transmission, or an ACK for a retransmission. 5G supports up to 16 HARQ processes, and it is configurable. If it is not set, then it is assumed to be 8. Call block groups is one of the concepts in 5G HARQ. A transport block is split into multiple call block groups, and one CBG includes multiple call blocks. When retransmission is required, then it can retransmit only a single call block group. This is called per CBG retransmission, and it is configurable by a higher layer parameter called PDSCH call block group transmission. Otherwise, it generates one HARQ ACK per transport block. HARQ in downlink. G0P sends downlink scheduling information via DCI with HARQ process information. NDI, or the new data indicator, will let you know whether this is a new transmission or a retransmission. If it is a new transmission, then it will clear the soft buffer. If it is a retransmission, then soft combining will be performed. Then G0P will send the transport block via PDSCH. Then UE will report HARQ ACK or NAC by calculating the checksum. If it's a NAC, then G0P will schedule the retransmission. HARQ in uplink. DCI will send the uplink grant, and then UE will send the TB via push. The checksum will be calculated at G0P. If it is a NAC, then G0P will schedule the retransmission, and NDI will be used to inform the UE.